Hey everyone, I have a quick one today. I've been working on an arrange view for this with multiple tracks that I can record to and play back from, but it might be a while before I get that totally working and integrated with the main code. In the meantime though, I got all the various audio inputs working and I wrapped them up into what's essentially a voice recorder. So I thought I'd share that in case this software by itself might be useful to anyone. The idea behind this piece of code in the grand scheme of things is to 1. Have a way to set up recording inputs, which includes picking the source, selecting whether you want to monitor the audio input, and adjusting the input gain for the signal. 2. It's a way to quickly and easily record big audio files and keep them for later when you're actually ready to lay down your tracks. Functionally, it's pretty simple, but there are a couple features that I want to point out. So the first screen I see is the main recorder menu, and it shows me a couple of important elements. Right up top is the source, which shows which of the audio inputs we're getting the data from. Using the arrow keys, I can scroll between the microphone, line input, and radio, which of course refers to the FM radio module we installed in this thing. Scrolling to the right one more time brings up the radio setup screen, but I'll get back to that in a little bit. Returning to the main recorder screen and looking a little further down, the next thing you'll see is the status graphic. At the moment, I have a gray circle telling me that I'll be recording to file 2, and that the system is available to record. If I hit the record button, the graphic changes to red, and I'm sure you know what that means. Pressing it again stops the recording and brings me back to the idle screen. Similarly, pressing the other buttons, preview, erase, and save updates the status graphic accordingly. The next graphic element is the input gain slider. If I have the microphone selected as my source, for example, turning the red encoder lets us adjust the preamp gain from 0 to 62 dB. For line input and radio, the range for the slider is 0 to 15. The gain control is used in conjunction with the peak meter displayed on these LEDs to choose an input level that doesn't lead to clipping of the source audio signal. The last thing on the screen is the monitoring section. I can press on this green encoder to enable or disable the monitoring option, and all this does is pass the audio at the input straight through to the output so we can listen to what it's going to sound like when it's recorded. Finally, that little arrow on the top left corner of the screen indicates we can scroll left with the yellow encoder, which brings up the recordings file browser. This just shows me all the recordings I've already stored, and I can scroll through these, preview them, or erase them as I need. Let's take a closer look at these features using some examples. I'm going back to the main recording screen, selecting the mic input, and turning the monitoring on. Now you're hearing my voice through the device's output. I'm using a little omnidirectional electret condenser microphone, and obviously we're not going to get spectacular audio quality from it, but it's certainly not awful either. It might be possible to upgrade the audio quality by replacing this with a better microphone capsule, but I haven't looked too much into that yet. Also, if you've seen the last video, I talked about the old design having an issue with electrical noise interfering with the microphone signal. Well, as you can probably hear, there's little to no sign of that buzzing left in this new board, and my voice is coming through pretty clearly. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, I can watch these peaks here and adjust my gain to control the loudness of the recording. As I turn the gain down, you'll hear my voice, as well as the signal noise, get quieter. And as I turn it up, my voice gets louder up until the point the signal starts to clip. Now before we move on, I'm going to turn monitoring back off and switch to my regular vocal microphone. Next up, I'm switching over to line in, which lets me record any line level audio I can feed into this 3.5mm jack up here. On the other end of this cable is my iPad, and I'm just going to play something from Spotify. When I hit play, you can see the metering LED start displaying the signal peaks, and if I turn on monitoring, we can hear the signal that's coming through. Now, setting up the line input gain, especially when using headphone level signal, is kind of a balance between setting the volume on the source device and adjusting the input gain on the receiver. What I'm going for is peaks that stay within the yellow region or below, and no noticeable distortion on the audio. I have the iPad volume set at almost the maximum, and my input gain is set at 4. If I increase it, you'll see the peaks going into the red zone, and the audio begins to distort noticeably. If I go too low, we stay in the green zone, but the signal ends up being too quiet and we lose resolution. Finally, let's take a look at the radio. Now, I can't explain why, but I've been having more fun with this radio than anything else on this device so far. Like, am I crazy, or is there something really cool about being able to grab music out of thin air? Anyway, I've navigated to my radio configuration screen, which features a little picture for radio, which I'm really proud of, and I'm gonna go ahead and turn my little radio on by pressing this red encoder. Of course, if I want to hear anything, I'm gonna have to go back and turn monitoring on. Now I'm filming this indoors, so for better reception, I'm plugging in this cheap external antenna to this port on the side. Of course, I can just as easily plug in an extra pair of headphones or any other piece of wire with a 3.5mm jack at the end to use as an antenna. Now I can use the red encoder to scroll through radio stations in my area. Now if I want to record a snippet of this, I can go back to my recording menu and just press the record button. I can keep this going for as long as I want, since this is getting recorded to my big 32GB SD card. But I'm gonna stop it right now by pressing the record button again, and preview it with this button. If I don't like the sound of this, I can go ahead and erase it by holding the erase button and confirming the action by pressing the center button, according to the instructions on the screen. The record file is emptied, and we can make sure of that by holding the preview button and hearing that nothing is played back. Now I'm gonna keep monitoring off and make a new blind recording. I'm gonna preview it real quick. And if I decide to keep it, I'm going to go ahead and save it. You can see the file number increments, indicating we're now recording to a new file, and if I go to the file screen, I can see the recording I just made. Using the same preview button as before, I can go ahead and preview the file we just recorded, or any of the other recordings. If I want to get rid of one of the files, I can use the same erase procedure on this screen to get rid of the record file. And that's all there is to it. As usual, you can find my code at the link in the description. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.